In this edition of Model S Explained, as some of you have already known or heard, a Model S owner claims that he got out of a vehicle and magically his Model S summoned itself into the back of a semi-truck trailer, or is it the front of a semi-truck trailer that was not connected to a semi-truck. And he claims it did this all on his own with no intervention or interaction. Now, Tesla logs say the opposite, and from what I'm understanding with the Tesla logs and what their statement so far has been, is the car had auto summon activated. What is auto summon? There's an auto summon available where after you exit the vehicle, the car will automatically park itself, same as you would if you used your key fob to do the regular summon. So instead of using your key fob to automatic summon or to summon it into or out of your garage, so on and so forth. And of course, you can hit the key fob to any of the door handles or the app to stop the vehicle from summoning. He used something called the auto park feature. Let's explore that after I make sure my audio's off. Okay. And let me put my seat back a little bit here and get my. Okay, here we are. We're sitting in my driveway. You know what? Let's pull it forward to, let's simulate the car going forward instead of backwards. I'm going to back it up a little further because I don't want it to summon into the roadway. Okay, so now I just hit park. We're in park. Got it? Simple, right? All right, now press the park button twice as you just saw me do. Let's do that again. Cancel. Okay, car's in park. All right, let's just say, okay, we're going from drive. Now we're in park. Double press, and we have auto park pop up. The car will move after you exit the car and close the doors. Now you must select either summon forward in auto park or go backwards in auto park. This is meant so you don't have to go through the hassle of getting out your key fob, holding it down, waiting, then having it start move. This is after you get out of your vehicle, it will just go ahead and do it, such as opening your garage door, pulling itself in, and closing your garage door. So we're going to auto park forward. Press any door handle or the key fob button to stop the car. Get out my key fob. And it fails to say you can also use the app, which is probably the slowest version or way to do it. So auto park enabled. The vehicle is waiting for me to exit the vehicle. And keep in mind, four-way flashers are also operating. Okay, now without me doing anything. And the proximity thing also stays into effect. So the key still is supposed to be within range of the vehicle. So there you go. At this point, crunch, crunch, crash is when the Model S hit the semi-truck and got the beams through the roof. I'm going to stop it before it goes into the road. There you have it. That is the, what I gather, given all as evidence provided so far by both by Tesla, is what happened. And even if you use the fob and accidentally press down, butt press your key button. Not only would you have to press it down, then you'd also still have to hit one of the other buttons. And now these buttons on the Tesla fobs, there's some good resistance. Just the way the whole plastic's designed, it's not, well, it's easy to single press a button. It's not easy to single press a button and hold it, then magically hit another button. I mean, I'm not going to say it's impossible. Well, the car is steering itself. It's trying to aim itself into my garage. We're not going to do that because I have a teardrop trailer in my garage right now that I'm working on. And I'm also building a tree stump log table. It's soaking in the stain right now. So, anyways, that is how I gather the accident happened. Now, why didn't the car stop itself? Here's why it didn't stop itself. The sensors of the car are designed for detecting, reasonable objects that are on the ground. You got sensor, radar, not used for auto park, sensor. Likewise, let's go around the back. The Model X has sensors in the doors. Sensor. And of course, your good old faithful autopilot camera. Now, the autopilot camera, I do not believe, at least in my own tests so far, the autopilot camera does not appear to be used in auto park summons. It is used for the initial detection of a parking space for parallel parking and perpendicular parking in partial, not wholly, but in partial. So the semi-truck that had the beams sticking out the back would have came and I believe hit above autopilot camera level on the windshield, according to what I could see on the pictures. Unless the car completely screwed up and had the AI enough to falsify its logs, which I just don't see that happening. And if Tesla were to falsify their logs, which I also don't believe that happened, I mean, that would be a major scandal that would probably ruin Tesla. So I do not think Tesla falsified their logs. But if it somehow the AI managed to do it on its own, I mean, actually, that would be a good sign, meaning that these things are learning. Or it could be a scary sign, but come on. This is just another case, in my opinion, of someone effed up and is trying to blame somebody else. Plain and simple as that. Been there, done that. See it all day, every day, constantly. So many stupid people. So on and so forth. So that is my opinion on the whole incident. Questions, comments, feel free to post below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Of course, feel free to hit up my Facebook page, and also like and subscribe to my Facebook page. So, now that that is over with, I need to get back to work planning for our upcoming Tesla party. Please see my Tesla party 2016 video for that details. All electric car owners and those parties interested in electric vehicles are invited. Salute!
Smile, cheese!